Buenos días. ¿Cómo está usted? ¿Qué pasa? What's happening? ¿Qué pasó? What happened yesterday? I think the future is ¿qué pasará? What will happen? God knows. So we are reading in Hebrews 11 in what's called the Hall of Fame of Faith. Examples from the Old Testament of people who pleased God, who were heroes. Were they men and women? Were they perfect? No, not yet. Did they make mistakes? Yes, seguro, for sure. Were they esteemed by God? Yes. By what means? Their faith, their trust, their assurance and confidence in things hoped for, the future that God had promised. Their total assurance of things not seen, as in God, who was leading them, like Abraham, who we read about. Listen again. Verse 9, 8, by faith, Abraham, by faith, he went out. He called to go to a place he would later receive as his inheritance. He obeyed and went. He left everything, took his family, and went out. And if you stopped him and said, yo, Abraham, Abe, where are you going? I don't know. I'm just heading west. First up, really north to Haran, then west. To the land of promise. How will you know when you will get there? I do not know. But the one who told me to go, I'm trusting him. When you get there, how will you live? Do not know. Faith is so radical. Oh, when Jesus comes again, he said, will he find faith on the earth? We got to know everything. I'm speaking for all of us. We got to know everything. We're not stepping out. We're not crossing the street by faith. He went out not knowing where he was going. That kind of primitive faith, you rarely find it today. My wife and I, by the grace of God, have stepped out over the years and did some things by faith. And we have found out that God is faithful. But how can you find out that God is faithful until you step out in faith? So I want to apply this in a different way today. I feel impressed to do this. Let's stay on this verse. This verse has meant a lot to me over the years. So the first thing that God ever said to Abraham, if you go back in the beginning of the Bible to Genesis, Chapter 12, I think it is, yes. The Lord had said to Abraham, go from your country, leave your country and your people and your father's household to the land that I will show you. That's the first thing, Genesis 12, verse 1. The first thing that God ever said to Abraham was, get out of town. Leave where you are. I have great plans for you, and I'm going to bless you and make you great and give you a land, but it's not where you are. You got to leave. To where? I'll show you. How will I know when I get there? I'll show you. This is the reality of what happened to Abraham, called Abram back then. I wonder if God isn't trying to break through to a lot of our lives and say, leave where you are. I have something else for you. No, no, I grew up in this church. I can't leave. I'm not saying you should leave your church. But how many people do I know who have dried up on the vine? Because my grandma went here and my father went here. And I was born a Baptist, going to die a Baptist. Or die at Assembly of God, whatever. They're not moving anywhere. Why? This is where I am. Does that follow? Does that make sense to you? Some people are to stay, but God has them right where they are, and they're going to be a blessing. But where's improvement? Where's change? No, I don't want change. I was told by my book agent one time years ago, you know, Jim, when you write about change, people are very scared of change. Well, then how will God lead us unless we're open to change initiated by him? This is the way I live. No, God has something better. There's more of the Holy Spirit. No, 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 no. No, but it's in the Bible. No, this was how I was raised. Not changing, Brother Jim. It's not true to life. It was Charles Finney who said, most people don't change 95% of their belief system that they had when they just were 1 year in the Lord. However they were saved, whatever church structure, whatever traditions, that's it. No mas. They're not willing to leave. We leave where they live. I'm not saying everyone should be leaving, going. I'm not saying that. But my goodness, the greatest stories in the Bible are people who left what they were used to go to something that God had for them. Like Abraham. And he dwelt in tents to the day he died, and yet God had promised him a land, as we're going to learn. But he was living by faith in a living God who moves us, who shows us new things in Scripture. But if we're locked in, know this is what I believe, I was taught, that's it. I'm not talking about new revelation. I'm not talking about being a fanatic. Come on, you know me better than that. I'm talking about greener pastures, something more that God has for us, not settling for the same old, same old. I talk to ministers and say, listen, I'm trying to follow that path myself. Could it be God is saying to you, leave and go to some place? I know, but I got to know where I'll land. No, go, trust me. I just met with a couple yesterday, beautiful couple. Carol and I talked to them. They once lived here in New York. And in fact, the wife, she worked for my wife. And they're up in upstate New York. They can't find a church if their life depended on it. They're so sad. The church they're going to, you know, this new thing has done, just these ideas that people get. The church has been painted black on the outside, now on the inside. Why? Because you want to draw Gen Z and it has to look like a club. Yo, you got to relate and it's got to be all black so that they don't think they're going to a church. Like, no, I'm just hanging at a club. That's a really spiritual idea. That'll really change people, the color on the walls. So they hardly preach the Bible. Nobody gets saved. The people who come don't live any different, but don't rock the boat. So I said to that couple, and I love them a lot, maybe God wants you to leave and go, but where? I don't know. But to go to church every Sunday and be frustrated, could that be the will of God? To know there's going to be no food on the table, no hardly mention of Jesus, no truths as found in the Bible, and yet we got to stay here. No, you don't. I'm saying in the name of the Lord, present your bodies as a living sacrifice and say, God, this cannot be your will that we dread going to church as we're driving there on Sunday. Show us where we should be. That's not against any church or for any church, but my goodness, if you're not being edified, but it's hard for us to step out because faith to us is a scary thing, but it's not when you realize that God said, surely goodness and mercy will follow all the days of your life if you follow the shepherd and go where he leads you. Let's do it by faith. Amen. See you tomorrow.